Hi, welcome back to my channel on this beautiful Saturday morning. I am in between chores. I not too long came in from doing some run around, and I thought I have 5 minutes to just sit down and throw out a video. Why not? I'm not busy on this beautiful Saturday morning. So I am going to do a review on this perfume. I have a sample. Child, I have lots of samples. Where I live, there's no possibility of getting full bottles of these perfumes. So I have to do samples and order from overseas and so on and so forth. So I'm not taking the risk of blind buying expensive fragrances without knowing if I like them or not. So one of my strategies was I was Googling some sites that would do samples of a lot of these popular perfumes. One, of course, is soulavantgarde.com. The other one is twistedlily.com. And Sephora has some as well, so you can always check those out if you want to try before you buy. So one that I tried, I'm still in the house of Nishane. I did a live a little earlier. I was just testing out, you know, I'm new to the YouTube, so I just tested out the live option. But I decided, let me come back to the video, and I'm going to do a very short review on this one here, which is Nishane Vain and Naive. I know it's probably backward. Nishane Vain and Naive. So let me just give you the notes quickly on this one. Top notes is all citrus, orange and bergamot. Then we have the middle notes, where we have the fruits and the plums, raspberry, plum, rose, jasmine, and cedarwood. And then in the dry down, my notes I have here, sandalwood, tonka bean. I'm not wearing my glasses, so I'm squinting. Sandalwood, tonka bean, musk, benzoin, patchouli, and amber. And I think they have this described as an amber floral, which is why I picked it up. Because if you watched a couple of my videos previously, you know that I told you that I love amber. It has to be amber floral, amber woody, amber. Once it's amber, I am there. So I thought this has to be perfect for me. And this is an example of what I mentioned earlier about not blind buying. Because sometimes you read the notes. Sorry about the noise. You read the notes on Fragrantica and you think you like it, but then it may not necessarily pan out. So let's get into this. I wore this last week, and I'm thinking, if you know ambers, for me an amber is like a resinous, incense-y kind of vibe of a fragrance. This one on me pulled nutty, milky, woody. That was what I got. From the time I sprayed this on, the top notes, the orange and the bergamot disappeared on my skin almost immediately. The raspberry and the plum, I got it maybe for like 5 minutes. And then all I got from there was this nutty, milky. Because I said, does this have a milky note in it? And of course, I know that the perfume houses don't always put every single note out there in the public. But just based on Fragrantica, there's no milk. And I don't typically like milk. I don't like to drink it. Coconut milk, not for me. Milky, not really my thing. So I was kind of disappointed because that's all I was smelling for the entire day. Milky wood with a slight nuttiness to it. I don't know if the nuttiness is coming from, I don't know, the tonka. I don't know where it's coming from because there's no almond or... there's no nothing no mentioned. And when I was reading a couple of other reviews on Fragrantica, a couple of people were saying that for them, they got a creamyish, milky, nutty vibe as well. So that's all I got with this one, Vain and Naive. Child, I'm not vain and I'm definitely not naive. This for me is not going to be a full bottle purchase. I'll just use this out. But when it's gone, unfortunately it's gone. It's I don't even know how to, it I could tell that with this fragrance, if I spread this on a lot more, it would upset my stomach. It has that kind of, it's not overly sweet, but somehow that milky note in this was just throwing me all the way off. And I love cedar. Like, I have a humidor here in my house, and every so often I open it just to smell the cedar. I love the smell of cedar. And this, the cedar, that typical cedar smell that I like, was just toned down to this milky fragrance. And I couldn't understand why. Why am I smelling milk and nuts? Not my favorite, guys. But I'll play with it some more and I'll see what happens. I'll see if my nose changes, or maybe on my skin it changes. Let me just say though, when I came home, I took a shower in the night, I put it on again because I said, let me see if profiles a little differently in the nighttime because it's a little cooler. And to be honest, I did get more of the plums and the raspberries. They lasted a lot longer, and the citruses, they lasted a lot longer on my skin in the nighttime, I guess because it was cooler. But then once those notes kind of disappeared, it was back to the milky, nutty, woody vibe again. So I'm not saying it's not a good fragrance, it's just for me and my preference on my nose, it didn't quite work out, or it hasn't worked out. I don't know if it'll change during the course of the weeks, but I'm going to try it again, and I'll see what happens. But thanks for listening. Thanks for stopping by. If you like this content that I'm trying to put out, hit the like button and subscribe, and leave a comment. Let's chat. Bye, guys.